Let's see mutual inductance of two coaxial solenoids. In general, the mutual inductance of two coils depends on the geometry of the coils, size, shape, number of turns, etc., the distance between the coils, the relative orientation of the coils, and the nature of the material on which the coils are wound. Let us consider a long air cord solenoid P primary of length L and area of cross section A having N1 turns. Let a shorter secondary coil S having N2 turns be wound closely over the central portion of the primary P. Let I1 be the current in the primary. The magnitude of the magnetic field inside the primary is in SI unit given by B equal to mu naught capital N1 upon L I1. The magnetic flux linked with the primary due to the field B is also linked with the secondary because the secondary is bound closely over the central portion of the primary. Thus, the magnetic flux linked with each turn of the secondary is phi 2 equal to BA equal to mu naught capital N1 upon small l I1 into A, where A is the area of cross section of the secondary, although it is almost the same age of the primary. The total magnetic flux linkages through the secondary is N2 phi 2 equal to N2 BA equal to mu naught N1 N2 I1A upon L. By definition, the mutual inductance of the two solenoids is M equal to N2 phi 2 upon I1 or M equal to mu naught N1 N2 A upon L. If small N1 be the number of turns per unit length in the primary, then small N1 equal to capital N1 upon L, and we have M equal to mu naught small N1 capital N2 A. If an iron core be placed inside the primary, the magnitude of M would greatly increase. Coefficient of coupling. The coefficient of coupling K of two coils is a measure of the coupling of the coils and is given by K equal to under root M upon L1 L2, where L1 L2 are coefficients of self-induction and M the coefficient of mutual induction of the two coils. K is always less than 1. Let's see inductances in series and in parallel. First, see inductances in series. When two coils of inductances L1 and L2 are connected in series and a current I is passed through them, the total flux linkage phi is the sum of the flux linkages L1I and L2I, that is phi equal to L1I plus L2I. If L be the equivalent inductance of the system, then phi equal to Li. Therefore, Li equal to L1I plus L2I, or L equal to L1 plus L2. This is the required expression which holds provided the two coils are separated by a large distance so that there is no flux linkage in any coil due to the current in the other. When the separation between the coils is small, there will be a mutual inductance M between them. In this case, the resultant induced EMF small e in the two coils is the sum of the EMFs E1 and E2 in the respective coils, that is E equal to E1 plus E2 equal to minus L1 delta I upon delta T minus M delta I upon delta T plus in bracket minus L2 delta I upon delta T minus M delta I upon delta T. It being assumed that the coils are so placed that the flux linking each coil due to the current in itself is in the same direction as the flux due to the current in the other coil, but E equal to minus L delta E upon delta T. Therefore, minus L delta E upon delta T equal to minus L1 delta E upon delta T minus L2 delta E upon delta T minus 2M delta E upon delta T. Or L equal to L1 plus L2 plus 2M. If, however, the coils are so placed that the flux linking each coil due to its own current is opposite in direction to the flux due to the current in the other, then L equal to L1 plus L2 minus 2M. Let's see inductances in parallel. Suppose two coils L1 and L2 are connected in parallel between two points and a current I is divided between them, then I equal to I1 plus I2, or delta I upon delta T equal to delta I1 upon delta T plus delta I2 upon delta T. When the currents through the inductances were growing, induced EMFs were set up in them. As the potential difference across each coil is the same, the induced EMFs must also have the same value, E, say. Thus, E equal to minus L1 delta I1 upon delta T equal to minus L2 delta I2 upon delta T. If L be the equivalent inductance, then E equal to minus L delta I upon delta T, or E upon L equal to minus delta I upon delta T equal to minus delta I1 upon delta T plus delta I2 upon delta T equal to E upon L1 plus E upon L2, or 1 upon L equal to 1 upon L1 plus 1 upon L2, or L equal to L1 L2 upon L2.